everyone, so I thought I'd make a video about my top 10 Xbox 360 games. Okay, so I should probably format this in some kind of order. I haven't done that. Okay, so at number 10 for my Xbox 360 game is Call of Duty 2. Now the reason I'm saying Call of Duty 2 is, for me, I'm not a huge fan of the Call of Duty series because I feel like it's just been overkilled, and I prefer Doom and Wolfenstein, you know, and that's just my retro gaming forever loves and nostalgia feels. But this is probably my favourite Call of Duty of the series, simply because, I don't know, I just feel like this I had more fun with, and I'm not really looking at the story mode, although the story mode is good. The multiplayer on this I found really, really fun, and people actually still go on this, so yeah, if you're bored, it's definitely a good game to go on. And as I say, I know it's not the most recent, or perhaps not even the best Call of Duty, but it's definitely my favourite of the series. I actually enjoy playing this one, whereas others I haven't really enjoyed, so yes. Fabulous. I nearly said number two. I'm so dumb, like literally. Number 9 on my list, I'm choosing Bayonetta. And there's loads of stickers on that, but yeah. If you haven't played this, it's an absolutely brilliant game, and I feel guilty putting it at number 9, to be honest, because it is just so fun, and saying number 9 out of 10 just sounds a bit wrong to me for this. It's just, it's a really fun game, and it's just brilliant, and I just remember playing a lot of it. It's very, I don't know. Very combat based, you'll pretty much always be fighting something. The story isn't great, difficulty depends on how you're playing it, but even normal is pretty difficult. But I'd say it's definitely worth a go. I really enjoyed it, so yeah. And as you can see, apparently Edge found it to be 10 out of 10, so you know, lots of other stuff as well, so yeah. Yeah, I just think it's really fun. You play as Bayonetta, and you can use her hair as a weapon. Like, that is just epic. And you can turn into a panther. And lots of other cool things. And the boss in Bayonetta is one of my favourite bosses of any game. Ever. At number 8, and again, I feel guilty putting this one here, but anyway, Mirror's Edge. Now, I'm sure a lot of you have heard of this game. If you haven't, it's essentially like a, it's sort of a, like a parkour kind of thing, because you're, but the controls are really smooth on it. You're basically running building to building and trying to complete story mode and stuff, and you're in a society where things are kind of, I don't know, they're really tied down by the government, I don't know. I could just read the back of it, because I don't pay attention to the story very much. In a city where information is heavily monitored, where crime is just a memory, where most people sacrifice freedom for a comfortable life, some choose to live differently. And they communicate using messengers called runners. And Faith here is a runner. And she, one of the rules in this city is to not associate with the colour red, because that's what runners wear. And she happens to wear red. I think it's just a really cool concept, and I just love it, and it's really fun, and I just spend ages running around on it. It's just really cool. So yeah, get this. If you haven't played it, I would recommend playing it. It's a brilliant game. You won't regret it. I'm really bad at summarising some of these games. My mind is just blank today. Anyways, number 7 is Just Cause 2. Just Cause 2, I remember when I played on this, I was like, wow, because it's so open world, like, the map is so big, and I never did the missions, I didn't find them fun, but it's one of those games that, you know, some games you have to sit down and really get immersed into, and you can't really stop playing, because the next time you go on, you're like, what am I doing? But this is just a pick up and play kind of thing. So if you're bored, I'd recommend getting this so you can just go on it. You basically play as this guy called Rico, aka Scorpion, I think he's called. And you can just do all sorts of cool things. You can go into loads of vehicles, you can parachute around everywhere, you can even get into massive jets and planes. That's another thing, is that aside from GTA, I'd say this is one of those games, probably just underneath GTA, where you can pretty much have any kind of vehicle. You know, cars, planes, all sorts of stuff, motorbikes. It's just really cool, and you can just drive around for ages, and the grapple hook thing, it's just hilarious. You can have so many funny moments with it. You can grapple hook like a civilian to a tree and they'll just be like, "Whoa!" And it's just very funny. So yeah, I find it very amusing and very cool to just pick up and play. At number 6 on my top 10 is the Orange Box. This is sort of cheating, so what I'm going to do is just pick one game out of these three to put in as my number 6. And for me, that's just that's very difficult. But I would say Portal is my favourite. So yes, Portal's an incredibly innovative game, and it uses physics and just the way that you think about problem solving in situations, so that way you can go through puzzles and a really cool story. And GLaDOS is hilarious. If you haven't played Portal, then definitely play it. But just remember, the cake is a lie. Don't get your hopes up. There you go, internet. I did a reference. Oh, ho, ho. At number 5, I choose Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. Unfortunately, I don't have the case with me, and I don't know whether I have it on Xbox Live Arcade, but it was certainly my favourite of the entire series. One, good start, but I didn't really enjoy it that much. Two, the introduction of Ezio, and it was a perfect game. I absolutely loved it. But Brotherhood had lots of cool additions to the gameplay features, and I just feel like it perfected it. The idea of having your own Brotherhood and your own sort of team to back you up was awesome. But the only one, well, I've got a couple others, but this was Revelations. I did really love this. However, I don't know, I feel like Brotherhood was just perfect for me. I don't know. This one, I didn't really enjoy controlling old Ezio. He was okay, but I prefer Brotherhood, to be honest. And, yes. And three. I'm not crazy about 3, and I haven't tried Black Flag, but Brotherhood is my favourite, so yeah. If you're new to the Assassin's Creed series, I would recommend getting Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, as well, that's the one I certainly enjoyed the most. It's just perfected all sorts of cool stuff, so, you know, you could be in battle with somebody and you can get your entire team to wipe everyone out. No problem. So yeah, it's just really cool, and I enjoyed the story, I enjoyed everything. And Ezio is the best in the world. I'm gonna leave it there. Number 4, to those of you who may have seen a couple of my tweets, or perhaps watched a couple of my videos already, you may understand my obsession with a certain game. Yeah, I kind of had to put this in somewhere. Dishonored is an absolutely brilliant game, and it's, I don't know, like, for the Xbox 360, this is one of those games that just absolutely, like, I've been immersed into games so much because there are so many great games, but this one really, really pulled me in. Like, Bethesda always do that to me. They give me a game and it just happens to be one of the best things I've ever played. By chance. So, yeah, Dishonored's really cool. You play as Corvo, who is trying to avenge the death of the Empress, and yeah, and save her daughter, Emily. And it's a really cool story, but the story isn't really what I want to rave about. It's more the gameplay aspects, the controls and how you can just move around so swiftly. The idea that you can either go through killing whoever you want, or you can try and get no kills, which is way more difficult. And I spent a long time trying to just not kill anyone on each level. But yeah, it's just really cool to see how it all unfolds and everything. And you can, you've sort of got a powering up ability with what magic powers you want to use. Magic powers, that sounds so dumb. Supernatural abilities. You can choose which ones you want and which ones you want to power up. So you can play the game how you want to play it. And I think that that's really cool because you can have a different experience each time you play. Number three. Oh, you might all be mad at me for this one because it's only number three. But yeah, I don't know. I feel guilty putting this at number three. But in the end, it comes down to just how I feel about the games. And I'm sorry, GTA 5. I know it's great that it's in number 3, but I'm sure a lot of you would put it in number 1 for the Xbox 360. I absolutely love GTA 5. The story's brilliant, the characters are brilliant, especially Trevor. He's my favourite by far because he's mental and he's awesome. The multiplayer, at the beginning, obviously a lot of bugs going on, but now I'm pretty sure they've sorted it all out, so I enjoy that too. Lots of new mechanics and the game, you know, the fact that you can be one of three characters at any time during the story and you can make your own customised character for online. It's certainly the best for the GTA series. And yeah, it's just a brilliant game. But the reason I didn't put it in number 2 or number 1 is because, well, gosh darn, some of the games have taken up far more hours than this has in the Xbox 360 time. That's a weird thing. Lifespan, that's a better one. But yeah, it is really fun. I really enjoy it, and I'll never get tired of the GTA series, even if they're up to number 100. I will never get tired of it because it's fun. And I never thought anything could beat GTA 4 or The Ballad of Gay Tony and The Lost and Damned, but this proved me wrong. So, again, if you want to play a GTA game, yes, is what I'm going to say to that. Right, number 2 is Fallout 3. As you may be able to tell, I am a huge fan of Bethesda. They are one of my favourite companies when it comes to games. I find myself getting so immersed in their stuff. So, yeah. The reason I'm saying Fallout 3 rather than Fallout New Vegas is because I just preferred the theme of this game, and I just felt like I was far more immersed into this than I was in Fallout New Vegas, and I enjoyed myself on this way more. I can tell when I enjoy a game more because I'll actually, like this, I've completed, but New Vegas, I'm not really that bothered about. It is still really fun, but this probably wins it for me. And it's like as soon as you come out of the vault, I'll always remember, like, the landscape in front of you is just brilliant. It's like, yeah, that's when I knew I was in for a really enjoyable experience when I played this, because you just see the scene and you're like, yeah. And also, this is one of the few games that I've played through that has made me cry. I was a blubbing baby, I think twice. So, maybe 3 times, but let's pretend I never said that. Anyway, that's how immersed I got into that game. It's just fantastic, you know? Just get it. And at number 1, and I actually feel quite satisfied with putting this at number 1, it's gonna have to be Skyrim. I love Oblivion, but Skyrim is my favourite of the Elder Scrolls series and my favourite from the ones on the Xbox 360. It's just so fun. And you can just, I feel like, awesome leveling up on it. Like, if I level up and I can improve maybe my smithing skill or, you know, my heavy armour or my speech or anything like that, I just feel really good about it. And I just feel like as soon as I go to fight an enemy, I'm immediately way better. And just, I'm invincible, you know? And I can as soon as you go on this game, you can do whatever you want. You know, you don't even have to do the main quest. At the moment, I'm playing through it, and I think I'm like, I started a new save, so I think at the moment I'm like a level 15 or something like that, and I haven't even gone to the Greybeards yet. So I'm there completing a ton of missions and levelling up quite a lot, but I haven't even gone to do the main story, and there's nothing wrong with it. You know, you can, if you just play the game just with the story mode, it's great, but it's also great to explore the land around you, which is very expansive and just amazing. And you can, you know, do all the side quests and everything. The side quests, a lot of them are really, really good. So I would highly recommend this one to those of you who maybe don't have Skyrim. It has got bugs in it, but come on. Bethesda are quite known for having a couple of bugs here and there in their games, but yeah, I cannot recommend that enough. This is the issue with not having discs for your games. I entirely forgot about Minecraft. My god! Right, that can be joint number one with Skyrim, because my god, that and Skyrim, okay? Those, Minecraft has just melted away so many hours of my life. It's been fantastic. I remember the first time that I went on it, and it was just the tutorial. As soon as I saw it came out on Xbox, I was like, oh, I've heard of this Minecraft, what, the ultimate lord PC race play. So I played on it and I was like, whoa, this is cool. And yeah, I love it. And I'd say everyone should own a copy of Minecraft ever, because there's no end to the game. It's the only limit is your own imagination. So if you've got a pretty cool imagination or a creative mind, you don't even have to have those. You can just go on, build a little village, but it's still really cool to pick up and play. And they update it all the time, which I'm not sure if I like or not, because whenever I go on it, I'm like, what's all this new stuff? I'm so scared. Turns off Xbox. So yeah, that's why it'd probably be joint with Skyrim, actually, because as awesome as it is, I just get bewildered all the time. Anyways, can't believe I forgot Minecraft. Oh. So, those are my top 10 Xbox 360 games. I do wish that I had mentioned some other ones, but they didn't make the cut. And, you know, some games like Fable, The Lost Chapters, and the original Fable, they're for the original Xbox, so I can't put them in. But if I did, and if it counted, that would be even better than Skyrim, because Fable, The Lost Chapters is my life. It's a very good game. But anyway, that doesn't count, though. That doesn't count. So I'm going to leave that one out for now. But yeah, I recommend all of these games because, and it was very difficult choosing from my collection anyways, but I just think these are really good, and you'll have a lot of fun with them. So yeah, if you have the time, definitely invest yourself in one of these games. I don't know if they're in the right order, but there they are. Yeah, and I think that about wraps it up from here. Thanks for watching the video, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you maybe consider playing on these games sometime, because I can guarantee that you will have an absolutely brilliant time. So if you enjoyed the video, feel free to drop a like on your way out. That would be really cool. And if you want to see more from me, maybe even subscribe, and I will try to get the content out. I'm doing my best at the moment. I'm trying really hard to get things actually going, and it's difficult, but I'm trying my best, and I'm actually sort of getting there. And of course, if you want to contact me, you can either leave a comment down below, or you can contact me on my Twitter, which I'll leave in the description box. I'm pretty much always on Twitter, so don't worry if you think I'm not going to respond, because I will. I will definitely respond, because I, as I say, I do not come off very much. So yeah, as I said, I hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you for watching. I will see you when I see you.